Hello. In this video, I shall be discussing five topics. The first topic is leatherback sea turtle. So these are a kind of sea turtles. They have a leather back. So they are called leatherback sea turtles. These are the largest of all the seven species of sea turtles. We have on our planet as a whole the seven species of sea turtles. So the leatherback sea turtles are the largest when compared to all other amongst all the seven species. And they are also longest ranging sea turtles, which meant they are present everywhere. In every ocean we can see these sea turtles. So they range from Indian Ocean to Atlantic Ocean or Pacific Ocean, except in Arctic and Antarctic Oceans. They are present in all oceans. So they are longest ranging sea turtles. That means they are distributed everywhere, almost everywhere in all oceans. These are included in Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So we have, India has got this particular act to protect wildlife, that is Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. So these sea turtles are joined in Schedule 1 of the Protection Act. That means they are going to get highest legal protection. It means nobody is able, could be able to simply hunt down these turtles or sell these turtles for any leather purposes or any other thing. So they will be having legal implications when these are exploited. So that is, they are going to have highest legal protection. These are also seen in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So as these are islands, we see many turtles over there. And recently these turtles have entered into news because there is this proposal of tourism and port developments coming up in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Due to these developments, hefty developments are proposed. Due to these, they will be disturbed. So their habitats will be disturbed, and even giant sea turtles, giant leatherback sea turtles are also found over there, and their habitat, and there is a huge concerns about the threat of their life and habitat if these port development and tourism projects would come up. So that is the recent concern about these sea turtles. So these are seen in Indian Ocean, as Andaman and Nicobar Islands are in Indian Ocean. Sea turtles in this Indian Ocean are going to be impacted with these developmental programs. So these conservationists and environmentalists have come up with this particular concern about their threat if these developments come up in Andaman and Nicobar. The next topic is Bhuvan. So Bhuvan is the name of an application, mobile application. So this is an alternative to Google Maps. So for location, for mapping and all, we mostly use Google Maps. So in order to alter these Google Maps usage in India, the recent application that has come up in India is Bhuvan. This is majorly done by ISRO with combination with an organization called Map My India. So Map My India is an institute, and with this institute, ISRO joined hands or entered into this memorandum of understanding to develop this app. ISRO is Indian Space Research Organization. So Map My India is an Indian IT company. So this would do the services that depend on locations. So location based services this company would provide, and this it does with indigenous satellite base. That means it is going to use some satellites that are developed indigenously in order to locate, in order to map. So this is something about Map My India, and it will help in digital maps creation that will aid in mapping, like the same lines of Google Maps. So the headquarters of Map My India is in New Delhi. So ISRO with Map My India has developed this Bhuvan app recently. The next topic is, it's also an app. The name of it is Sandesh app. So Sandesh app is recently developed by India on lines of WhatsApp. So this will definitely emulate, or this will definitely be on the lines of WhatsApp, because as an alternative to WhatsApp, due to some privacy concerns raised during COVID-19 time, the Indian government has thought of an alternative app. So Sandesh app is developed on WhatsApp lines as an alternative to WhatsApp in India. This is basically developed by National Informatics Center. It has come up with this app recently. This is a messaging platform like WhatsApp. And here there is some system called GIMS that is incorporated into this app, that is Government Instant Messaging System. So the privacy will be protected by the Government of India in this app. So Government Instant Messaging System is used in this app. So the features are same as that of any normal messaging platform, like you can forward messages, or you can send broadcast messages, or you can make groups in the app, and the emojis also will be as same as WhatsApp. So this is developed on lines of WhatsApp as an alternative to it by National Informatics Center. The next topic is World Bank report on road accidents. Recently, road accidents and deaths associated with road accidents are increasing in the world. So World Bank gave a report on these road accidents. So the title of this report, it named it as Traffic Crash Injuries and Disabilities, the burden on Indian society. So in India also, these accidents are increasing more and deaths caused due to these accidents are increasing. So this is a burden on Indian society, that is the traffic crash injuries and disabilities. So the title is given like this by World Bank exclusively for India, India side of report. So this shows that India contributes to 11% of deaths that are caused globally by road accidents. So out of all deaths, out of 100 deaths, 11 deaths are from India that are caused by road accidents. So this is the report that is brought forward, and this report is based on the data of 2019. It is, though it is released recently, the study was conducted on the accidents deaths of 2019. So not just World Bank, it also took the help of Save Life Foundation of India. So Save Life Foundation is a non-governmental NGO organization based in India. So World Bank took its help in noting down the statistics, in collecting the data and all. So both of them together gave this report. Save Life Foundation is an NGO that will look after the road safety measures and also emergency medical care whenever there is any road, huge road accident and all. So this particular thing is based on road accidents concept. So this Save Life Foundation helped World Bank in bringing out this report. So this is recently released in India by our Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari. So he released the report by World Bank, the titled as Traffic Crash Injuries and Disabilities, the Burden on Indian Society. So though this is a study on India, this is released by World Bank. The last topic for today is NS Vishwanathan Committee. So recently there is a committee constituted and the chairperson is N.S. Vishwanathan. He is the former RBI Deputy Governor. So Reserve Bank of India Deputy Governor. He was the former Deputy Governor. He is placed as the chairperson of this committee. We shall see about something about this committee. So this is an 8-member expert panel. So the panel has got 8 members, experts. This is constituted by Reserve Bank of India. And this, the basic theme of it is to strengthen urban cooperative banks. So we call them as UCBs, urban cooperative banks, or primary cooperative banks. UCBs, urban is also called primary. So primary cooperative banks or urban cooperative banks are one and the same. So this is to strengthen these cooperative banks. So in this, they're going to evaluate some regulatory measures that RBI took up to strengthen these banks so far. So urban cooperative banks will have a different view from RBI because they are for socio-economic objective to increase the social and economic conditions of people. The measures that RBI has taken so far in strengthening urban cooperative banks will be evaluated by this 8-member expert panel. So in the last 5 years, what steps RBI has taken to strengthen and how well they are doing their work, how well these urban cooperative banks are strengthened and what measures are further needed, and all of that study and evaluation will be done by this 8-member expert panel. So the objective of this is to strengthen urban cooperative banks, and the objective of urban cooperative banks is socio-economic progress in that particular area. So this is the recent committee. So these are all the 5 topics for today, and thank you.